What is up, guys, and welcome back to the channel. It's Friday! It's like the best day of the week, right? You get to sleep in on Saturday, you get to be hungover on Sunday, but today is the special day on the channel. It is Classic Friday. As always, guys, thank you so much for all the game recommendations in the comments section on last week's. Now, last week's episode of Classic Friday was a little bit dark, and then the week before that we had Grand Theft Auto 1, and then obviously we had Soul Reaver the week before that. So it's been kind of gory thus far, and I wanted to take it to a more softer place this week. And what better a game than Spyro the Dragon? Spyro the Dragon was the first ever PlayStation 1 game that I ever owned. I remember my mum coming home with a PS1 from my brother and I, and I can't remember what game he got first, actually. I think it might have been Gran Turismo. But for me, I got Spyro the Dragon, and I used to fight with my brother constantly because I just wanted to play it 24/7. I didn't want to share. Luckily now, I don't have to share, and guys, please hit that like button because I know you guys love Spyro. Hopefully next year we are gonna have maybe a reboot of this game or something. I pray so hard. But for now, let's create a file and let's get into it. I've literally not played this since I was a little girl. Oh man, it's beautiful. I think, yeah, in the world of dragons, this is the one where you have to save all the dragons. Unfreeze them, I think.
Okay, rolling.
Oh, it's been peaceful here in the five worlds, or is it six, for a dragon's age. We now have 12,000 treasure, or is it 14,000?
What about this Ganasty Gnort character? Now, I understand he's found a magic spell to turn gems into warriors for his cause.
I'll take that question. Nasty Gnort is a simple creature.
Simple.
He has been contained in a remote world and is no threat to the Dragon Kingdom.
No threat!
Besides, he is ugly. That does it!
Looks like I've got some things to do.
Oh my gosh, I don't remember it starting like that. That's why you don't call people ugly, and especially why you don't call bad guys ugly. Because they will freeze you. Oh my gosh, my little heart. It's bringing back so many memories. Hey, Nestor.
Thank you for releasing me, Spyro. Free 10 dragons in the artisan world. Then find the balloonist. He'll transport you to the next world.
What about Nasty Nork? I'm going after him.
Find dragons first. That's all I can tell you.
What would you know? You literally just got frozen by some guy because you called him ugly. You should have known better. You should have known. Do I have analog? Oh my gosh. I actually have analog. Delvin!
Where's Nasty Nork? I'll torch him.
Keep your horns on, Spyro. You have much to learn first. Do you know what the dragonfly following you is doing? His name is Sparx, and he's helping and protecting you. Keep an eye on him and see what I mean.
All right, I'm keeping my eyes on Sparx. So if I remember the third game, you could actually, oh, can I swim in this game? I don't know if I can. So triangle brings my camera back round. I have the worst OCD when it comes to this game because when I used to play Spyro back in the day, I had to collect absolutely everything. See, Sparx makes that kind of easy, shall we say. Thomas!
Hey, Spyro, press the jump button twice to glide. And don't be afraid.
Afraid? Of what?
Falling from high mountain peaks? Plummeting into prehistoric glaciers?
Oh, that.
The thing I love about classic games is like, there's none of this 20 minute intro sequence. Oh no, 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 no. It literally throws you straight into the game, straight away. And that's just it, basically. Wait, can I get up here? No. How did I? Hello? Bonk. Oh, I missed him. Get here. Yeah. Ow, sorry, that was gonna be painful. Wait, oh my gosh, I remember those sounds. It sounds like tinnitus going through your ears, and I'm sure when I was a kid it used to actually upset my ears. Haha, give me all your gems. So when I start playing games like this again, it just makes me want to do a full series on my channel. Ooh, we got a level here. Should we do that level, or should we look around a little bit first? I kind of feel like I want to glide on these things, though. Oh! Oh, no! Oh, Suzy. Well, that's okay. We can come back there and get some more stuff. So let's just go and have a little look around. If I recall, I can actually collect the dragons a second time. Okay, hop to it. Oh, I just remembered the egg thieves. They're like, me, 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 me. Boom! Get back here. Boom! Ooh, you got lucky that time, sir. Aw, oh, what? There's so many of these guys here. Oh, sorry, Spyro. Sorry about that. It's so funny, actually, playing this game just now. Oh, hello. I got a life. I think when you grow up with certain games, you always think that they're... I don't know what the word is. I guess a memberry is probably the best way to describe it. If you guys watch South Park, you know what I'm talking about. Where you always think that everything is awesome because you grew up playing it, and then you kind of play it again when you're a little bit older and you're like, oh, maybe that wasn't like the best thing in the world, but I mean, I grew up with it, so it must be good, right? Oh, I know I can get up there. I just need to get my controls. Oh, excuse me. Look at all the goodies! I think this is where the balloon guy hangs out. I don't know why, but the balloon guy used to scare me. You know what? Get zapped. Get zapped. Yeah, there he is. Marco the Balloonist. If you prove your worth by rescuing 10 dragons, then you may use this balloon to fly to a new world. Get burned, balloonist. Yeah, I don't think I can swim in this game. I think that's the third one. I never played the second game, so I couldn't possibly comment. Bah! Alright, let's go and do Stone Hill. I'm so excited. I don't remember any of these levels whatsoever. All I remember is the na-na-na-na-na egg guy and then collecting dragons, and that's all I remember. Potentially, this could be the na-na-na-na level. That's just what I'm gonna call it. Oh, sorry there, Spyro. Can I jump in this well? Aha! Oh, what? Oh, dragon!
Watch the dragonfly, Spyro. His color indicates his power. When he eats butterflies, he stays strong. Like me.
Sure.
I honestly, I don't remember Spyro's voice actor. I don't know if it's Elijah at this point. Elijah Wood, I think his name is. I don't know if it's the same guy now, or if he was just mostly the new ones. Ow. He's a really good... Oh, I was close! Ow. Yeah, he's a really good voice actor. He did Spyro... Bah! Justice in the later games. Although, to be honest with you, I wasn't too keen on the PS2 version of Spyro. It was too linear for me. And all the enemies were exactly the same, and there was no fun when it came to the level design. Uh-oh! Got ya. This just makes me want to play the third one now. Hopefully, as I said in the intro. Gee-dum! Oh, they're not lives, are they? I don't know if they are. Yeah, I'm hoping that we can get a reboot of these games. Please.
After you freed all the dragons, pass through this fancy vortex thingamajigger. It'll take you back to the artisan home. But first, let me tell you a story.
No thanks. See ya.
You know, Spyro, you should respect your elders, my friend. Shouldn't be so rude to the old people. I don't know how I used to play these kind of games, though, and not get motion sick. I don't know if it's just the... Maybe I sat further back as well. I'm kind of, like, in my TV's face right now. Dragon!
When you free a dragon or step on one of their platforms, you're saving your progress. That could be useful if you run into trouble. Not that you ever run into trouble, Spyro.
No, I never, ever run into trouble. Thank you very much. Actually, maybe it's not this one. Because I remember they're egg thieves, are they not? And I don't think that they were in this game. Wait, so how many... Is that it for this episode? Surely not. Surely not. Do I have like, 3 of 4? No, I'm certainly not done here. I'm missing like an entire section. Is it down here? Aha, there we go. Aha, I hear you. I hear you. Me, 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 me. Yes, it is this one. I can see he's on the hill, if I remember. I gotta get him. For old time's sake, it's gotta happen. Just make sure I get all of these. Thank you. Who's this dude? Well, he's gone now. I thought that potentially he was friendly, but oh no, I could be wrong. Whack. So that's 140. I've missed any. Not that I can see. Right, I'm gonna get this little ninja thief. Me, 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 me. Hello? Wait, is there a dragon? Oh, there is!
Spyro, my friend, how about a hint on gliding?
You bet.
For the longest glide, press the X button at the top of a jump. And try pressing the triangle button to drop down in mid-flight.
Okay, so where is the best... No. Look, he's over there! Oh, I'm gonna get him. I am gonna get him. So, let's just see if I can make it across here. Oh, easy peasy. All right, I am coming for you. Ooh, or I'm coming for the edge. Oh, he's on the other side. I'd like to try and at least get all the gems. That would make me happy. But nothing would make me happier than taking out this thing. Come on, you. Yes! That was easy. So it's funny that you get eggs. I understand why I would get eggs in... Oh, goodness me, that's the edge of the map there. I understand why I would get eggs in the third game, but in this one, I never really understood why. Alright, I've had to move back a little bit because I could feel myself getting slightly motion sick, and obviously I don't want that, so... Just for my own sake. Moved back. It's something that I've always had to deal with, is motion sickness when I'm playing games, and it sucks so bad, but it is what it is. So we've got all the dragons. Now if I was doing a full let's play on this game, I'd be very likely to try and get absolutely everything, but because I'm not, I'm happy enough with my progress. Ouch. And I'm gonna return home. So we got all the dragons in that section. I don't think I missed too many, actually. Whoa! They're back again? Whoa! Hey, you've got goodies for me. So there was a level there. We've just done this one. So let's go ahead and take a look at this level in here. What's it called? Dark Hollow. If I remember this one was actually relatively tricky. Was it not? I think it was. Go on, Spyro. So I want to know, what is your favorite Spyro game? I can't see. Oh, this is the one with the big fatties in it. Ouch. Gotta set these on. Ah! Come here. Yeah, I want to know, what is your favorite Spyro out of all of them? I haven't been hit yet. Ooh, dragon!
Big enemies like this Gnork with the club cannot be charged. But a quick flame, that should defeat them.
I know this. I already got this. Oh, hello. Just shoot them a few times, just in case. Just in case. Sparx is getting all sorts of num-nums. Yeah, I am most definitely struggling with motion sickness on this one today. I don't know why. I mean, I used to play this game. Well, that's the end already. I used to play this game all the time when I was younger. As I say, I 100%ed this numerous times, but I don't know. Maybe it's the lack of the camera could do it as well, because I know the Manhunt gave me a little bit of motion sickness last week, and then was it Soul Reaver? Soul Reaver also gave me a bad case of motion sickness. In all of these games, you're not able to control the camera, so I don't know. Maybe it is something to do with that, or the colors, perhaps? Could be the colors, but I don't know. I don't know. But I'm gonna power through it, because that's what I do. Gotta do what you gotta do. Bah! Aha! Dragon!
Oh, it's you! I wasn't sure if you'd escape those annoying little creatures. Of course, they wouldn't bother me, but here's a hint. Metal armor is fireproof, but a charge attack will take care of them.
I've already figured this out. I know this. So wait. Is there any more dragons? This area seems really small. It's funny because in the third game, the levels in this are... Yeah, there is a third one here. There's also one at home, too, that I've completely missed, so... This is down. Oh. We have a tunnel. Hello. Oh, what the heck? How do I get him? In the butt, maybe? Oh, well. Should I get him in the butt? Ah! No! Leave me alone!
Spyro, want to know a secret? Use the triangle button when you want to zoom in and look around. Oh, your secret's safe with me.
But it's not even a secret, everybody knows. Everybody knows. So that is all the dragons. Oh, there's the key, look. Oh no, poor Sparx, damn it. Right, let's get the heck out of here. Oh no. I gotta get past this guy again. Ah, let me past! Aha! So you can't fool me. I just don't like these guys. Wait, let me... Aha! See if you burn him from behind. That's how you do it. So I think I've got enough dragons now, so I'm gonna go ahead and leave this level. I think that's up here. Whoops. Yeah. So let's go ahead and leave the level, and then I think that's enough to get onto the boss, maybe. But unfortunately, guys, I'm having to stop this video short. I was hoping to do the boss for you guys, but for whatever reason, this game is just making me horribly, horribly motion sick. It's not something I've ever experienced with Spyro the Dragon before. When I was a kid, I used to be able to play this game for hours on end, so I'm not really too sure why it's making me motion sick. I have been feeling kind of poorly this week anyway, so maybe that had something to do with it. But yeah, as always guys, this has been Spyro the Dragon. Please let me know of any other game recommendations, leave them in the comment section. I hope you have a fantastic weekend, and I will see you all next Friday for another Classic Friday. Bye guys!